Professor Milk, oh. Hello, class. A lot of people have been telling me they want me to do something other than 80 carries for these milk guides, as that's been the majority of my channel, and I've taken that into consideration. So I'm pretty excited about this guide, and I hope you get excited too. Jinx is a very interesting champion, unlike any other marksman, and with the current iteration of items and balance changes, I would hate for you to take the wrong approach to playing her. I've been playing Jinx since her release in Season 1, just after they switched back Corki and Pantheon's ultimates and finally took away Janna's bleeds. So it's safe to say I've got the credentials to back up this guide. I've played countless ARAM and Dominion games with Jinx, which gives me the much needed teamfighting experience that Summoner's Rift typically lacks. Thank you for joining me in Jinx, your first taste of Elo Heaven. I'm Professor Milk, let's get started. First, let's go over Jinx's abilities. Switcheroo. This ability lets you switch from your Pow Pow minigun that fires 4 autos at once at short range to a much longer range, not so mega miniaturized version of the Death Rocket that does AoE damage at the cost of 20 mana per auto. Zap, Jinx's W. This spell has a disgusting AD ratio on it for insane damage. For a bit of relativity, it does about 1/8 the damage of Annie's point-and-click Q, or 1/16 the damage of a sheened-up critical strike by a Q-empowered auto from Talon. Flame Chompers, E. This spell is Jinx's highest damaging ability. After her ult, zap, and basic attacks, it's used much like a bear trap to incapacitate their adversary's legs, rendering them useless until 1.5 seconds is up, then it politely lets them go. Side note, Flame Chompers have an excellent AP ratio. Hey, I'm just letting you guys know, take from that what you will, I just give the tips. Super Mega Death Rocket, Jinx's ultimate ability. In the last patch, Hi-Rez Studios nerfed the directly into your mouth hole Jinx ult, so that it's just as useful as the invite to private chat room option in the client when you're trying to snoop on someone's match history. Awkward. What to take from this is that once you hit 6, you need to be alert, constantly looking around the map for mid to long range snipes. Fortunately, they did buff Jinx's ult, but didn't put it in the patch notes. I believe we call this a ninja buff. If you shoot your Death Rocket but don't want them to dodge it, simply tap R again while it's flying to make it invisible. Do this every time. There was a huge debate on my Yahoo Answers post about which ability to max with a focus on Switcheroo and Zap. Since we didn't come to an obvious conclusion, I went to AskJeeves.com to get a solid answer. And after that gut-wrenching, nostalgic letdown was over, I came to my own conclusion. I max W because I can land it with 100% accuracy in lane, but I don't want you guys to go through all that hustle-marustle. So I suggest maxing Q because while you'll probably misclick your autos, just use attack move. At least you'll be doing damage to something. I'm going to introduce you to the latest milk build, and then we'll use the next few minutes talking about it. Cue the dramatic music. Here we go. And building, boom, the milk build. Now let me, along with some pals, explain exactly why it's the best build. Before I chime in with my own facts, I would like to add a new segment to these videos, called Wise Words from the Pros, or Retired Pros, and other high elo players that aren't necessarily professional, but understand the game well enough to give a valid opinion. I'll work on the title, but these guys are great. They've achieved such a high level of mastery, you actually have to give them money to speak to or ask them a question. Here's our first guest, Geronimo. Geronimo is a high elo AD carry player and streamer that claims his Draven is better than Fabi's. But until I see a 1v1, the truth, much like the release date of Riot's replay system, is still up in the air. As a fallen challenger player, he made it his life goal to climb back up to the promised land where bitches flock in to watch him play League. At a $3 per question rate, we ask Geronimo,
is Runan's Black Cleaver, Vork, Last Whisper, Frozen Mallet good on Jinx?
After analyzing the build's strengths and weaknesses, he said,
no. Runan's is okay as a last item, but not great, because if they clump, you do a shit ton of damage because the rocket's AoE. Black Cleaver I would never get because she doesn't do well with CDR, or it doesn't affect her too bad. Blade is situational, Last Whisper is a must-have, and Frozen Mallet, maybe if you're really far ahead.
It's clear he understands the strength of Runan's, but his game knowledge falls short because he obviously doesn't see what this build is trying to accomplish. This is what's probably holding him back. And now, to our next guest, an ex-pro, a self-proclaimed carry lord. He showed us level 2 power spikes, Quin it to win it, and he taught us that a big dick isn't something you'd find in your pants, but what you have in your heart, and the only guy that would give you a blowjob when you're feeling your softest. Michael, I'm a cutie pie, Santana. At a slightly higher rate of $4.20 per question, we ask him,
Professor Milk is Runon's Bork, Black Cleaver, Last Whisper, Frozen Mallet, and Boo's Good Hunting.
Now, as we await his wise, veteran answer, I can honestly say that having the pie answer my question is not only a modern-day miracle, but an honor. He responded,
"No, that's garbage."
Eh, fuck off, man. At least Geronimo broke it down. I give this guy $4.20 motherfucking cents. Hey, the segment's over. Let me show you what this build is all about. In order to show the full strength of this milk build, I queued up for a ranked 1v3s versus my challenger friends, Sivir, Ryze, and Xinzaobot. I was going to invite Anibot, but he wasn't online while I was recording this portion of the video. Four things happen when you buy Runon's Hurricane on Jinx. You can get all the attack speed stacks from your Q with just one auto, which also applies AoE Blade of the Rune King on hit and Black Cleaver Armor Shred stacks. You get three separate AoE splashes from each Runon's Hurricane shoot while using Fishbones for amazing teamfighting. And lastly, since you have those three separate AoE splashes, if minions or champions are clumped right next to each other, you can get all six stacks of Black Cleaver off with just two autos, giving you 30% armor pen to shred those tanks. Runon's Hurricane is an amazing item that gives loads of attack speed, because much like my skill, I want my attack speed capped. The Last Whisper is simply to do more damage, and the Frozen Mallet is to help you with auto spacing. Now queue up, play Jinx, and experience the life of a carry lord. Godspeed. Professor Milk. Oh.